Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be redoing an old video of mine actually, the top 5 ways to get started freelancing within Salesforce. We're redoing it for a few reasons. One, I like to update these videos once a year so that I can give you the most up-to-date version. I believe that video came out July of last year, so it is about a year later. Also, two, I have significantly upgraded my equipment since then. I have a new camera, I have an actual microphone now that's a lot better, and it picks up my voice a lot better, and so it shouldn't be clipping at all like it was in that video. So thank you for your comments. I have upgraded my setup. But a lot of the information is still gonna be the same because it has only been a year, and Salesforce freelancing, well, it hasn't really changed a lot in the ways that we'll be talking about now. It is a lot more competitive. So while the things that are true last time are still true this time, you will need to do a lot more work to get clients and maybe be a lot more forward in reaching out to clients. One thing I do want to mention is that this is how I got my start within Salesforce. And now my husband and I together, we own a Salesforce consulting firm. And so I'm very familiar with getting clients and trying to figure out freelancing and then eventually moving on to the company aspect of that. So without further ado, let's get started in the video. All right, the first way is the personal way I got started on Salesforce. Consulting and freelancing is going to be through Upwork. This is a website where people will post their jobs that they need help with or their Salesforce projects that they need help with. And then consultants will reach out to these job listings or these project listings and say, hey, I feel like we would be a great match. I would love to do this. You'll answer likely a bunch of questions about your background and why you would be a good fit. And then the client will likely reach back to you, or they may not, or the job will close. These reaching out are done through what's called connects, and each job listing takes a certain amount of connects. And if you run out because you've reached out to a large number of people, then you'll either need to purchase more connects from Upwork or wait until the cycle of connects is reset. I'm sure that Upwork on their website has an overview of what that is, just a general overview. Upwork in the past has been really good for finding clients. And then also clients can search for you once you have accepted and done a job through their platform. This has been a really good way to get specific jobs in the past, not so good anymore because it is fairly crowded. Now, if you do have some specialty certifications, such as being a developer or having experiences or having CVQ certifications, this will greatly boost your success rate on these different platforms across the board. But this is really, really helpful as well. All right, so number two is going to be very similar to this one, or to Upwork, and this is going to be Fiverr. So Fiverr is another freelancing website where I believe it's the opposite way, where you are a freelancer and you post your services and how much you charge, a little bit about you, your background, maybe a portfolio of the different projects you've completed, and clients will reach out to you to complete a project for them. I have personally not been on Fiverr, but I have heard that it is pretty good on there, very similar to Upwork. All right, and number three, this is going to be a little different, but it is through blogging. So blogging to show that you have a certain knowledge to help a client. This is also could be another stream of income for you if you decide to put ads on that blog. But if you have a blog outlining the best practices for setting up a Salesforce org that you just bought or new Salesforce org, and then you advertise your consulting services at the end to be able to set that up for the client, that is a way for you to reach out to the client. Now this can be pretty difficult because you have to worry about having the website and designing the website and ranking in search and making sure that you're getting in front of eyeballs to promote your services. However, if you are doing this as a side hustle and just trying to build this up, so then in the future it can provide clients, then this can be a good way, as well as can be another form of income if you decide to put ads on that blog. Okay, and number four is going to be LinkedIn. Now, there are a couple ways that you can do this with LinkedIn. You can get into the LinkedIn groups and post your freelancing services and see who kind of bites on those groups. I haven't personally used groups on there, but they could be good. You can also look for contract work that's maybe part-time to be able to freelance within their job listing section on LinkedIn as well. You can also find a recruiter or a set of recruiters to say, hey, I would really be interested in doing some type of freelancing contracting work and explain the situation if you're looking to do this in addition to your full-time job, or if you're looking to have this be your job is just freelancing rather than having a full-time job. Number five is going to be to subcontract with a current admin. I have actually done this in the past where you work with a consultant and you work underneath them, and whenever they have a large workload that is overfilling their time, then they will pass on some work onto you for their client, whomever they're working for. So you'll be working underneath them with them. This could be great if you are a newer admin and you are looking to have some type of mentorship. This could be a really good route for you to get connected with another freelancer or consultant, independent consultant, to learn Salesforce. Freelancing can be a really great way to learn Salesforce. For me, it is actually personally really nerve-wracking to freelance, especially was in the beginning when I was still learning Salesforce. But as I got more comfortable freelancing, talking with clients, talking with customers, and knew what I was talking about and knew how to complete the projects they were asking me to complete, it became a really fun process and is still a part of our process today as we have created our consulting firm. So that is it for today's video. I hope that you found this helpful in some way, shape, or form. If you liked the video, be sure to like, subscribe. If you'd like to join the email list, you can do so at salesforceemily.com, and you can check out the courses down below. So thank you so much for watching. Catch you guys in the next one.